Have you ever walked into a massive office building, shopping mall, hospital, or airport and felt perfectly comfortable? Not too hot, not too cold, just the right temperature, clean air, and quiet hum of machines working in harmony. You might not realize it, but maintaining that perfect indoor environment in such large spaces is no small task. It requires an army of HVAC systems, heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, all working behind the scenes. And the commander of that army? It's called the Building Management System, or BMS. As buildings grow larger and smarter, the need for centralized and intelligent control becomes essential. HVAC systems alone can account for over 50% of a building's energy consumption. Without proper control, they can easily become inefficient, uncomfortable, and expensive to run. That's where BMS steps in, not just as a system, but as the brain of the building. Let's learn more about it detailed in this video. Welcome back to the world of HVAC with Mr. Smart. So, what exactly is a building management system? In simple terms, it's a centralized automation system designed to monitor, control, and optimize various building services, especially HVAC. Think of it like a digital supervisor, constantly watching over temperatures, air quality, occupancy, and energy usage, and adjusting things automatically to maintain comfort and efficiency. A BMS connects various subsystems of a building, like chillers, air handling units, ventilation fans, pumps, thermostats, and sensors, into a unified network. This network is monitored and controlled from a central location, often through a computer interface or touchscreen dashboard. Now let's break down the key components that make up this intelligent system. It all starts with sensors, the eyes and ears of the BMS. These include temperature sensors, humidity sensors, pressure sensors, CO2 sensors, occupancy detectors, and even light sensors. They gather real-time data from every corner of the building. This data is then sent to controllers, usually DDCs, direct digital controllers, or PLCs, programmable logic controllers. These devices act like mini-computers. They analyze the input from sensors and make decisions based on predefined logic or conditions. For example, if the temperature in a conference room rises above 26 degrees Celsius, the controller may trigger a command to start the air conditioner and adjust airflow. To carry out these decisions, the system uses actuators, relays, and VFDs or drives, the muscles of the BMS. Actuators can open or close dampers, modulate valves, control fan speeds, or switch equipment on and off. This creates a real-time feedback loop where conditions are constantly measured, adjusted, and stabilized. All this control and monitoring is visualized through HMI or SCADA systems. These interfaces display the building's HVAC status graphically, showing temperatures, alarms, energy usage, and system health. Facility managers can use this interface to fine-tune operations, schedule maintenance, or even receive automatic alerts when something goes wrong. Implementation of a BMS typically starts at the design phase of a commercial or industrial building. Engineers determine how many zones the building will have, where sensors should be placed, what equipment needs to be monitored, and how data should flow. The physical layer includes wiring, controllers, power supplies, and communication networks, often using protocols like BCNet, Modbus, or KNX to ensure that all devices can speak to each other. Once installed, the BMS runs on a control logic, similar to how a program works. Let's take a basic example. If a room is unoccupied for more than 15 minutes, the system can automatically reduce air conditioning and lower fan speed to save energy. If someone enters the room again, the motion sensor detects presence and ramps the HVAC system back up. This is called demand-based control, and it's one of the biggest advantages of BMS in HVAC applications. In more advanced systems, the BMS also incorporates scheduling, like turning off HVAC in unused areas during nights or weekends, or adjusting cooling set points seasonally. Some BMS platforms can even analyze historical data to detect abnormal behavior and triggers maintenance alerts, reducing downtime and increasing equipment lifespan. BMS also integrates with other building systems like fire alarms, access control, and lighting. For instance, during a fire emergency, the BMS can shut down air handling units to prevent smoke spread, unlock emergency exits, and activate pressurization fans in stairwells, all within seconds. In essence, a building management system transforms a passive building into an intelligent and responsive environment. It ensures not just comfort, but also safety, energy efficiency, and operational ease. For engineers, technicians, and facility managers, BMS is like having a powerful assistant that never sleeps and never misses a detail. So next time you walk into a perfectly climate-controlled space, remember, it's not magic. It's smart engineering powered by a building management system. If you found this interesting, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more deep dives into automation and engineering systems. Drop your questions in the comments. We love exploring the tech that makes modern life possible. Please have a look on our previous videos about HVAC system. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.